Attaboy.
God damn it. You never want to be the boomer. You never want to be the boomer. I'm going to play some music for the people here. We might get dinged on this, but this is a Dilated People song, Nick, so I don't care.
I like it.
What's up, Ronnie? Thanks for hopping along.
Yeah, I will say, it is a little different, though, on the digital platform. It would be nice hanging out with you guys in person.
We can't even see you. We can't see you.
I knew that's where Earl was going to start.
I got to tilt it.
Everybody. Swag's here with the prof and our boy back on. It's EPMD. Eric, a.k.a. Earl, back on the scene. So
he's a very studious, Earl.
Yep,
today.
I have the glasses on. Yes, I do.
And the EPMD jersey that was all over social media. It might be up for sale later this week. I don't know. I heard maybe that was going to be a
auction.
So what?
Can you turn around and show everybody EPMD?
Yeah. We need to see the EPMD, bro. Come on.
I'd have to take off the shirt and take off the headphones. How about the end of the show?
You should have wore it backwards so that we could see the front.
Yeah.
Well, you can see the Bridgeport Rip House. I mean, check it out on Facebook. You know what it says on the
bones.
Back.
Bro, the bones are a popular requested jersey.
The most polarizing jersey in Norristown softball history. So there's people that love them and think they're the coolest things ever, and there's people that think they're the most atrocious pieces of clothing to ever be made.
These are big facts. Big facts. Yeah. What you heard Earl chirp when we started was we had a text going about getting a podcast in this evening. And I was asking Earl if, you know, he had a PC available to him or he could maybe use the application. The first thing he says is like, man, I don't know about this digital stuff.
Yeah, I'm not too good with that. I'm an in-person type of guy.
Bro, look, you're live. You're in color. It looks good. Everything works.
I know, right? Not bad.
Quarantine times, Earl. 6 feet apart, brother. 6 feet apart.
I hear you.
But we're happy back. We told everybody when we got the last podcast in about 8 days ago that we were going to be back on a weekly basis, on a regular basis, and we are. We got a ton to talk about. Before we went live here, we were talking about a bunch of Netflix stuff we want to get into. But there has been some news in some of the sports topics that Nick and I talked about last week, and I wanted to lead off because we know Prof loves his NHL. So we were talking last week about, you know, NHL doing its sort of bubble play, not much of a bubble like the NBA, but what would be the cities that the NHL would play in? Well, ironically enough, the day after Prof and I got done with our last show, the NHL decides that Vegas is out, and I don't think that anybody here is surprised that Vegas is out. So there's only two cities left. Prof, pick up on it. Tell us more about it. I know you know all about it.
Toronto and Vancouver. So that was the one I was missing was Vancouver. So but I had heard that Vegas was a done deal. Like it was one of the definite spots. So obviously I passed that on, and I was very excited about that. But Vegas is actually it doesn't seem like it would be. But for people that don't watch hockey, Vegas is the best arena in the NHL. It's been voted the best fan experience. It's the best arena, and you got to hear it when you actually watch a game when they're playing in Vegas. It's insane. The crowd's going nuts. They have things going off here and there. It's like it's an experience. So I think that was one of the reasons that they were probably pushing for Vegas. But anyway, Toronto and Vancouver, they started back up on Monday with the training camps. So we're starting to see clips on Twitter again of guys making crazy saves and guys making crazy shots. So that's cool that we're finally got some sports Twitter back going again, beside just stupid polls and, you know, eliminate one, you know, what's your favorite fast food? What fast food would you eliminate? What other stupid things are going on Twitter? But finally we're seeing some sports back and it's been nice. So the plan right now is to get everything started. I think it's on August 1st is the first set of games. So they have two arenas they're playing in. They're going to play, I believe, four games a day at these arenas. So they'll get started at noon. Then you'll have a 3 o'clock. Then you'll have a 4 o'clock in the other arena. And then you'll have a 7 o'clock. So that's pretty much, I think that covers it. There's a round robin piece to it. So the top four teams are in basically a round robin to play for that, I guess, that top seed. And then there's series going on for basically the play-in round. So did I cover everything?
Yeah, that was good. So I wanted to ask one thing, and Ronnie brought up a point about the Redskins. We're going to talk about that. I don't want to leave that behind. We were talking about that too. But for the first thing that Nick said is he said Vegas was voted on to be the nicest place to play. And right away, why? It's a brand new stadium, right? Because the Black Knights are a brand new team. So everything there is brand new, I would assume, right? I mean, they didn't just pull that up out of nowhere. They built a stadium for them.
Golden Knights.
Yeah, Golden Knights. I say Black Knights. Who are the Black Knights?
It's a Golden Black Knights, isn't it?
I think
it's the Golden Black Knights.
There's a Black Knights too, right?
I don't know.
Rutgers is the Scarlet Knights, right? Isn't that Rutgers?
Is it UCF?
UCF is the Black Knights, I think. Somebody's the Black Knights.
I think it's UCF in Florida. Yeah.
So
they're Knights.
But, I mean, obviously, the concern that we talked about last week with using Vegas, even though the facilities are great and it would be a great place to host, was the virus uptick, right? And then as soon as it happened, they're like, yeah, we can't do it here. So moving both cities to Canada makes sense. Prof laid out the plan for you. It makes sense. Yeah. Let's just hope it goes off unhinged, right? The real problem is, and this is going to be in every sport that we talk about with coming back, is first, how many players are going to opt out now? Hockey's a sport where hockey players are different breed, right? They're kind of half nuts. So I doubt there's going to be very many of those guys opting out like we're going to talk about in basketball and baseball. But we'll see. Hopefully, I mean, I'm pumped, as I know Eric is and I know Nick is, to get some sports back. So hopefully, we've talked about this last week. We really like the NHL's plan. Hopefully this gets kicked off and everything goes according to plan and we get some hockey.
Honestly, it seems like there, you know how we had to pick last week the one league that we would think that would play, you know, had the best odds of playing. It seems like the NHL is on track for that. Because I don't think I've heard, and I don't know if you guys have heard any players that have opted out, but I don't think anybody has.
It's been a couple that were positive, but they're all in.
Yeah, so they test positive, then they quarantine, and then they have to do two negative tests in consecutive days, I think it is, and then they're back with the team again. So
yeah, and the bubble is the way to go too, because the baseball they're traveling, they're still traveling from city to city. They're still going. I mean, yeah, I think they are like constructing it, like all the east side. You know, they're all trying to keep it like closer together in the states. But that's why I think the bubble with the hockey is going to work a little more, because they're in the bubble, they're in two areas, and that's it. I mean, because they're traveling a lot more in baseball, so it may. Well,
I thought baseball, when it's come time to play, they're going to be in Arizona and Florida, aren't they?
I thought they were going to the cities. At least what they say on the radio.
Maybe I'm wrong.
I don't know. Somebody enlighten me. I thought they were going to the cities and they were playing at the ballpark, but nobody in the stands.
Just looking at the schedule, I don't know how possible it would be to do that, because looking at the schedule, it looks like they play the Yankees one day, then the following day they play the Mets, and then it's like
– But it's all East Coast, like I said, though. They're all keeping it –
I'll look into it.
Prof will look into it. The way I understood it was the Arizona and Florida with the complexes, but, I mean, baseball's a sport where we've already had the most players opt out. To your point, though, Earl, the bubble's the way to go. Prof and I talked about this a little last week with – the Knicks, the Knicks were talking about it because it was in the news in New York, but with basketball and with quarantining in Orlando, right, with the way that they were going to do it with the stadium rotation going on, or makeshift stadium that they're setting up down there. So funny things that have been coming up now, because the NBA sort of trying it out, right? They've sort of put together makeshift practice arenas in like hotel lobbies and stuff like that. But they've got these guys so quarantined that they're getting like bubble meals, and a bunch of the guys were posting on Twitter like their bubble meals, and it was like no food. Or like Joel Embiid said he was going to lose 20 pounds, which may not be the worst thing in the world for Joe, but
yeah, the one guy got 10 games quarantined because he ordered delivery. You know,
yeah,
I forget his name. I would need to check online.
Nothing outside
delivery. Eight days quarantine
at their ballparks without fans for baseball. Nick, you see different?
I'm all messed up here. Did somebody just play I was hearing like three different streams at one time.
Whoa. Probably got some cross interference. But Ronnie's saying that on the stream that the teams are playing at their ballparks for baseball. So that may be the plan.
God, I was right.
Is. I don't know how they think that type of travel would work.
That's, I think it's pretty crazy. I'm just trying to look at the schedule right now. And,
okay. Well,
I mean, I'm just trying to find the Phillies, what they're supposed to be doing. But I think they're getting started.
July 21st, Sunday. Right. Sunday's the start of it. Sunday is the first day.
Right, and then baseball. The full season starts.
And also, by the way, I don't mean to change subjects, but hey, we got Tiger Woods coming up too, playing the Memorial. I didn't mean to change subjects, but he just clicked. Yeah. Sunday, sports, baseball, and we got golf. My bad. I mean, Tiger's coming back. And I just had to say that. The Memorial.
About the NBA, though. About the NBA, though, if we can jump back.
Yeah.
There's been multiple videos of guys that are just outside the bubble. I did hear that same story of the guy that went to – he literally crossed the street to pick up his food, and he had to quarantine. He didn't, like, test positive or anything, but he still has to quarantine. Like, I just feel like they're not taking it as seriously. And I don't feel like they want to play. A lot of these teams that are not going to be contending, you know, we talk about it all the time. In hockey, there's always the ability for an 8 seed come out of nowhere and win a cup. Well, we always talk about how basketball, that's not the case. So there's a lot of teams going into this with really nothing to gain. It's really just being away from their family. It's being away from their homes. And so there's not a whole lot of motivation there. So that's why I feel like it's going to fall apart for the NBA.
Dude, I totally agree. Think about it like this, man. And we think about it. These are 21, 22, 23-year-old guys. They've been cooped up. First off, professional athletes. They've been cooped up for 5 or 6 months, right? So legitimately, while Eric is playing Xbox, by the way, this is awesome. So they've been cooped up.
I don't play Xbox, by the way. Months. I'm actually researching some good stuff.
And you
I'm
now
put them right down to go.
The complex. To Prof's point, on like a 7 or 8 seed in the East, they can't win a championship. They're going to come back and play games, but who knows? And then they have practice at this thing. They get sent a little meal to their hotel room, and then it's like, okay, guys, you know, burn your time, but you can't leave the complex. Bro, they're going to leave the complex. They're going to do whatever they want. They're not taking it seriously. Some of them, and they never are going to take it serious.
You saw the video of Ben Simmons, right?
Yeah.
Ben Simmons catches the fish, and he throws it out there. And I'm like, can he shoot the ball? He can't throw a fish off the damn dock. I know that.
You know? I did see that.
He's like, get out of here, dude. And he's just like, see ya.
Yeah.
But it looks like they're having a good time down there.
Well, some of the guys, you know, some of the veterans like Chris Paul was out in the yard complex there. They had their masks on. They were playing like cornhole and stuff. Some of the veterans, you know, they're taking it serious. But some of the young guys, you're not going to be able to control them because, again, even if they're taking it serious, like how serious is, what do you mean I can't walk across a block to get a pizza? Like that to them, that still shouldn't apply. They don't fully understand that being in quarantine bubble means no contact with anybody or anything outside of it.
Well, for the contenders, they're going to take it seriously. But for the other guys that are there for whatever teams have no shot, I don't think they're just going to be doing whatever they want to do. Now, if it was the beginning of the season, like we're seeing for baseball, I mean, yeah, okay, then there's some motivation.
Right.
So the NBA is in the biggest pickle because they have unmotivated guys that don't want to be there. There's obviously more to do in Orlando. I know Toronto and Vancouver are awesome cities too, but, I mean, there's a lot going on in Florida. There's more stuff to do, you know.
What do you mean?
I mean,
in Orlando, all they're doing is fishing off the dock. That's all they're doing. They're playing video games. You see all the videos of these guys bringing in their PlayStation systems in there?
Well,
I'm like, what else? They can't do anything. Joel Embiid's the best, by the way. He comes in there with a freaking Tyvek suit.
In a hotel room.
He's wearing a mask, the gloves, and everything. Yeah, I love that guy.
You were getting pinned up in a hotel room for, you know, the next 2 months, and you couldn't do anything. What do you think you'd be doing? You'd be setting up your Xbox, your PlayStation.
I got a PlayStation, 100%.
What you guys are doing?
Yeah, I mean, I would just be practicing, putting the work in, go back to the hotel and chilling out. I mean, that's all I would be doing. Sleeping, get a good night of sleep, hydrate too is a big one. That's all I'd be doing, man. Getting that ring. You know, LeBron's doing that, man. LeBron wants that ring.
Point.
LeBron wants that, you know, everyone's comparing him to MJ and Kobe. Yeah. You know damn well the only reason why he's doing this is getting that ring.
Of course.
Because he wants to be the best ever. So there's people are taking it serious.
And it's serious.
And it counts.
LeBron and your top 2-3 teams in each conference are 100% taking this serious, right? But, you know, the bottom half of the league, who knows? We'll see how it goes. Right now, on a confidence level, I have the NHL at the highest. The NBA sort of in the middle. I don't know what's going to happen yet. We'll see. But before we talk about baseball, because it came up in chat multiple times, the big news this week in the NFL was the Redskins announced that they will be denouncing the nickname the Redskins. So as of now, they're the Washington No-Names. So, of course, we had to go to social media and start asking everybody, well, what would you name the Redskins? So my favorite, before I asked these fine gentlemen, was, of course, from a tremendous movie, The Replacements, and it was the Washington Sentinels. Of course, it fits with the theme, right, because of the other teams in town, the Nationals, the Capitals. So it fits the theme, and they've already got those blue and red jerseys that they had from the movie. So I think it fits. What names do you guys like? What names did you want to hear? What cracked you up? Throw them out there.
You want to go first, Nick?
I'll go first. So I think the first thing that I would ask, so have they stuck with the idea of keeping the same color scheme?
No idea. No
idea. They are. They are keeping the same color scheme.
So first of all, by far, the ugliest uniforms in football, no?
Bottom five for sure. I don't know if it's by far. I mean, the Browns are horrible.
Browns. I like the Browns. Name a team after, poop. I mean, that's pretty bad.
Yeah. I mean, the Browns are horrible. You know, we used to have a saying in college. This is going to offend a lot of people, but I don't care. It'd be called a Cleveland Browner, and that was a good uniform, bad helmet. You can take that for what it means.
Yeah.
Good uniform, bad helmet.
You didn't offend me, Jack. You're good.
Okay, I got you. Anyway, so if they keep the same color scheme, the Sentinels are out. You can't be the Sentinels and keep a different color scheme than you had in that movie.
True.
So I've heard a number of different team names. Now, here's the issue. Here's why this hasn't been decided. There was a realtor in Alexandria, Virginia, who years ago, trademarked every possible team name.
I saw that.
And so now they're tied up in all kinds of trademark litigation trying to get the name rights. So I think what they're going for is the Red Tails. That's what I've heard.
I did hear that.
I heard the Red Tails.
That's the rumor. But usually the rumors aren't right. But
So it's a
Red Tails.
Fox?
It's a Fox.
Fox?
No, I heard it was about the airplane squadron in World War II. That's what I heard.
It could be a double, right? Because that would work too. I don't know. Red Tails? How do you feel about that? Red Tails?
Me?
I feel like they have to go with something red. They have to go with something red at the front.
Yeah. I thought something cool for them, and now I'm going to let Eric go. So I was watching a survival show on Netflix that just came on. It was called Alone. And one of the guys was in either West Virginia or Virginia, but like D.C. around, right? And he had these wolverines that kept coming after his moose kill meat that he had. And since they're in the area, and I actually had never seen a wolverine before until the show, I thought the wolverines would be cool. There's only one other team that I know of that's the wolverines, and that's Michigan, and that's college. So but the wolverines would be cool. I don't know how it would work with the maroon and gold, but wolverines are a cool name.
I think that's pretty sick.
Yeah, like the Washington Wolverines. You got some alliteration there with W. I thought that would be pretty cool.
It just doesn't – it could. It's a nice name.
Yeah.
But I'm going to add my point to it. This guy in Alexandria, whatever, he took all the names. And all. You know what you do? Don't pay the guy. Screw him. I'd be like, you know what? You going to buy all the damn names? You know, screw you, buddy. So you know what I call it? I call it the Washington Football Club. Keep it simple and easy. Give yourself another year, you know, if you want. You know, you don't have to make decisions. Cause it's the football club, isn't it? I, you know, it's just Washington Football Club.
I think that's lame.
I think
it's have a nice big old W. Listen, on there. I mean, you don't got to pay nobody. You own the rights to Washington, at least. You know, maybe they won't strip that away from you. You know, and by the way, you know, Snyder, people say, oh, why'd Snyder give in? Snyder never gave in. He was losing all his sponsors. FedEx was like, dude, man, we're not sponsoring no more. It's like, dude, everyone was out. You know, it's like big cancel culture coming in, saying, dude, we're not paying a lick. We don't change that name. And that's been going on for years. So I'd say just keep it simple. Just Washington Football Club and put a W on there. Same union, just a W, in my opinion.
They can't do that.
I'm not a fan.
That's lame. You need something. You need something behind the team. You need some reason. Like, you can't just call it a football club.
No.
But on top of that, you mentioned to do that so that you buy yourself some time to figure out a different name. They're not gonna brand their football team multiple times in the next few years. So you want to do it and be done with it.
I mean, the whole issue. There was one more I liked.
You
guys remember this, right? This came up a couple years ago when they were talking about should the Redskins get rid of their name.
But their sponsors weren't backing out.
Exactly.
And then the sponsors backed out. I was like, oh, damn, ain't getting paid.
Yeah, and the whole thing with Daniel Snyder always came back to branding, as Prof is bringing up. Like, this is – I mean, and by the way, the Redskins are a very old NFL franchise, right? So they've got years and years in history of branding and apparel and that logo and those colors, right? So – that's the real issue. The sooner they select something that they're going to stick with, the better. To Prof's point, I mean, it would be funny, right, if they FC'd it and then had, like, you know, jerseys released. They become collector's items in 30 years, sort of like Washington Sentinels, right, the idea of the movie replacements, because they're only going to be around for a short period of time until they rebrand. But they're going to pick something and then stick with it so that they can get their new logos out, get their jerseys reprinted, get their helmets going, get all their new flags out, get all the gear out. The question for me is, how will the Redskins fans culture change, right? Because what did they call Redskins fans?
Well,
pigs.
Yeah, the pigs. Yes, that's what I was going to say. The pigs. He was saying Red Wolves. Diehard.
Red Wolves.
This guy's like 40 years old. He's been a diehard. He's my Madden League. So anyway, I don't know him personally, but he's a diehard, and he changed his name to the Washington Red Wolves. Maybe that might be one.
Some people that I know that were big Redskins fans are already jumping ship. They're looking for another team.
Really? Well, that's tough to do if you're like a native to
– what's up, Tate?
Okay, so Washington.
And then here comes the downfall. So Tate and Ronnie, bring it up. So now the Redskins are falling, so what do you do with the Cleveland Indians? With the Atlanta Braves.
They already have a C on the hat.
Well, right, but they're still the Indians. But here's the thing. Redskins, I think, if I'm out of line here, tell me, being, you know, white guy over here, but Redskins to me is sort of a derogatory term.
It is. It was, but like, you know,
Braves a derogatory term?
I actually think it's pretty cool.
Me too.
I did hear a couple of things, and like it is with the Indians, Native Americans. Yeah. It was kind of glorifying, you know, of their, I guess, I don't want to get in trouble here, but but it was like glorifying their existence in this area, the country, I guess, right?
And that's what the
club is doing, and it's just like, you know what, cancel it out. It's offensive. Get it out of here.
They had the C on the hat now. We love the Major League movies, but like Chief Wahoo was a little over the top, right? I love the logo, but it was a little much. So
the Indians is a really, it's like really the one that's in the middle that you're like, well, you see why it's offensive, but then you also see why it's not. I mean, but I think when it falls in that category, just the way that things are in the world now, you have to go with the way of change.
So you think the Indians got to go too, yeah?
Yeah, I think if you have a large group or a large majority of people that are offended by it, I think you have to change it. And even Terry Francona came out and said that. He said, you know, I think it's time to, you know, to maybe move on from it.
So now, the Braves
and the Chiefs and the Warriors, I think that's a little bit different. I think that's on the side where I think everybody's pretty in agreement that
But here's another thing, though. I really think you can really nitpick. Go ahead. Sorry, Nick.
No, go ahead, Mike.
No, I was saying, I really think, like, a lot of these teams, you can really nitpick of, like, oh, hey, it's, you know, like the 49ers. Like, I've heard some history about them where out west they were minors and they were doing some stuff. I really feel like you can, like, nitpick at every team name. And it's just like, is everything all that offensive? And I guess with the Redskins it is, but I just feel like. If you ask the Indians, you know, Native Americans, are they really offended by the name Washington Redskins? And I guess the answer is yes.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, that's the one that really stood out.
Yeah, the Redskins has always been the one that stood out. And to Nick's point, the Indians flirt the line. And when you talk about the Warriors, the Seminoles, the Chiefs, the Braves, they're sort of on the other side of it, right? Because it's like proud heritage behind those names. Indians is not a term that Native Americans have adopted or prefer to be called. Definitely not Redskins. So yeah. On that side of it, they're gone. Tate's asking, what do we do with the movie Major League now? I mean, they won't do anything with the movie, right? The Indians were a team. Chief Wahoo's all over those movies. Those movies are classic. But I think that, and Ronnie says people are already throwing suggestive names out for Cleveland. I think we're in agreement. Indians is going to go next. Cleveland's going to have to go something else.
But I think the rest stay. Now the Blackhawks, I don't know.
Seminoles.
Well, that's the Seminoles, but the Seminoles are again. That's more of like a pride thing because this, I believe, and again, I don't know the history here, and between the Blackhawks and the Seminoles, but I believe that's like a tribe of Indians from the area, and it's more pride than it is derogatory. But I would
hate to see the Blackhawks go because they're probably one of my top three. Favorite uniforms, I think.
Our resident hockey guy here, hate to see Blackhawks go.
And they've been around forever, right?
You know, look at these franchises. The Chiefs are an AFC original team, right? The Indians are. When did the Indians come into baseball? Back in the 50s, I think, Prof. Maybe before that, 50s, 60s. The Blackhawks are an original 8 NHL team, right? The Redskins are.
They're pretty old.
Original 8. They might be an original NFL. Like these teams have been around for a long time. So, you know, there's a lot of history here between the branding and the team names and the cities behind them. So, it's a lot. But to your point, some of them got to go. Redskins are going. Looks like Indians are going to go next. We'll see about the other ones.
Yeah, like originally, obviously, I don't think it was ever intended to make these terms like to be derogatory. Why would you name your team something that you intend to be derogatory? It's just over time,
right?
We learn more and more, and you know, progress is a good thing, I guess, with this situation for sure. Especially with, like we said, the Redskins. That's there's really no two ways around it. That had to go.
Yeah, I agree.
Well, it's a shame because it's like, you know, I've always grown up knowing it's the Washington Redskins, but it's time to go and it's time to move on. It is what it is, and. Here's what I do hope. I don't care what their name is. The Eagles on Sunday are going to beat their butts. Beat their asses. I don't know if it's PG or not. So they're going to beat their asses.
Prof will get mad at you if you curse and you did it twice.
I don't know. It's just PG or PG-13. I don't know.
So
it's PG-13. You're allowed a few of them.
Yeah, you can get it. So leaving the topic, my final vote for the team name, I'm going Wolverines. Leave us with your final vote. I'm going Washington Wolverines.
Prof? Okay, I like that.
Oh man, I think I see the either the Red Wolves or the Red Tails. I think that was the best one that I read, and I think I could visualize the logo. I can visualize for some reason I can visualize like the Fox logo
or like the wolf head in the Redskin. Yeah.
Red Wolves or Red Tails.
All right, well that's my go here. I'm gonna go. I know I said the football club. I'm gonna go with the Washington Natives. The Washington Natives is mine. That sounded pretty right. It's not far off from the Redskins, the Washington Natives. That's
so. I heard you say that. I heard you say that last night. Is that something that you read, or did you?
No, I'm in a group chat. I will call him out. You know, Ben. You know, Benny. He was like, "Yo, what do you think about that?" I'm like, "I like that. That's actually a good call by you." I don't know. And plus, this guy from Alexandria, whatever his deal is, that's not on the list.
Doesn't have it on the list.
It's not on the list. I want to pay that guy a couple million dollars. For
no, hell no. So Tate's asking about franchises.
Final answer.
That we can throw out. So he's saying, do you think the Celtics logo isn't offensive to the Irish? Well, that's come up before. The Celtics have come up a lot. But
Notre Dame.
Yeah. I mean, well, Notre Dame.
Irish people like it.
Yeah, that's the problem. Like, that's Notre Dame and the Celtics, because of the Irish history in Boston and with the Fighting Irish. I think looking at the logos from the outside, you could say it's offensive, but just because of what's behind them in the history there, they're not, right? In fact, I mean, the Fighting Irish is every Irishman's favorite college team, right? Even if he has no affiliation to it. So, you know, I think it's kind of the opposite effect, which is ironic.
Yeah, with a drunk Fighting Irishman is your mascot.
I think the Irish, like I said, I'm Irish. It doesn't offend me, so right. I don't know. I like it. I mean, I don't know why. I have a couple of Irish friends that are way more Irish than I am, and they're diehards. I don't know. They would be highly offended if they removed that name.
So. Yeah, I think you would. It's never going to happen, right? To be outraged. I just keep thinking of the South Park episode with Russell Crowe, my boat tugger, and we're fighting around the world.
Dude, but honestly, we would have said that 10 years ago about the Redskins thing. We would have said that 10 years ago about the Indians thing.
Like I said, I've been saying it because you know how big of a fan I am of the Lebatard show. They've been calling it the Washington racial slurs for the last 5 years. I mean, this is not the first time that the Redskins have come up. So.
No, but I'm just saying, 10 years ago, we would have said, oh, they're never going to change it. Like, you know what I mean?
I'm surprised. Like, I'm surprised that from where they were 4 or 5 years ago with this to how quickly they shifted now, I'm surprised by that. Because, yes, 4 years ago, I would have told you I didn't think they would change it. But 4 years ago wasn't 4 years ago in terms of the state of the country, right? So,
exactly.
Yeah, I never thought they'd change it. I always thought Snyder would stick his guns and – he never would change it. But perfect example, money talks.
Yep, that's true. So a couple things that we wanted to throw out was what were we watching on Netflix? So I think we all had something we wanted to throw out. I had something that was sports related that was very interesting that came up. So new Netflix show called Home Game. And it's a mini series, and each episode, it's like 35 to 40 minutes long, has its own unique sport that's played in a certain part of the world. The very first episode, in my opinion, is by far the best. So it's a game in Florence, Italy, called Calcio Storico, which translates to historical soccer. And I don't want to give it all away, but imagine gladiators on a field of battle, trying to get a ball from one end of the field to the other. Each guy, it looks like a soccer player with about 45 pounds of steroid muscle on him, and he's a cross between a UFC player, a rugby player, and a football player. It's awesome. You got to watch it. It's a great episode. Crazy. You got to watch it.
What's it called?
It's called the show is called Home Game, and then the first episode is called Calcio Storico. That's Italian for historical soccer, and it's only played once a year. Four teams from each quadrant of Florence, it's regional, and they only play it once a year because it's so brutal. Like these dudes shit out of each other.
It reminds me of a sport that I just newly found on Facebook Live or on Facebook. This guy does some stuff. It reminds me of this game that they were playing. It's outrageous. I can say it real quick. Go ahead.
No, sorry, man. Go ahead.
So anyway, I was just going on Jack's point, it just clicked on me. So this is one sport like the Middle Eastern. So what they do is they ride. It's just like polo. They ride around horses, and so what they do is they got a goat, like literally a goat, a dead goat.
This is on this too, Eric. Right? This one
is that. Is that it? Okay. Well, I'm saying that. You just reminded me what you're saying. That might be it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So this guy's like, so what they do is they pick up the dead goat, and it's like polo, and they throw this dead goat in a big round circle sand dune thing, a big like gold thing, and I'm like, you gotta be kidding me! You guys are throwing around a dead baby goat. Pretty much what they do, and they fight over this thing, and it's pretty entertaining.
So I haven't watched the episode yet for that, but I saw the description at the end. Tate's saying he's getting fired up by my description. You should be. Let me tell you something. This Calcio Storico thing is insane.
You sound super white when you say it that way.
Bro, I can't believe how bad these dudes beat the shit out of each other. Like, it's crazy. Basically, there's 20 guys in the middle, 10 on each team, who their only job is to beat the shit out of the other guys. And then there's, like, fast guys at the back that run the ball to the goal. But, sorry, Eric, I did see that description for that on home game. It's one at, like, the very back of the season. I haven't got to yet.
But I forget what it's called, but it's true. Crazy.
Yeah.
So there's a couple games. So my old company I worked for, I worked with a lot of people from Ireland, and they taught me some of the Irish games that they play. Have you guys ever heard of hurling?
Yeah. So, okay. Another one on home game is the Highland Games.
Yes. So hurling is basically, it's like lacrosse meets hockey meets rugby meets soccer. And it's basically they just go around with pizza paddles and just they scoop this ball up and they whack it. It's like part baseball, part I don't know. You've seen it. How would you describe that? I mean, it's insane. Yeah. But they literally beat the crap out of each other.
Weren't they playing that game on Braveheart? I don't know. I forget.
Well, so okay. All right.
On Braveheart?
So in Braveheart, what you see. So if you watch, you got now everybody has to watch this show on Netflix because I think
I haven't watched
their third episode is the Highland Games. And what they do in the Highland Games is a form of what Eric was talking about in Braveheart, where William Wallace walks up to his buddy and he goes, "Hey, could you kill a man with that throw? I could crush you like a watermelon."
Like a
watermelon. So they have all those like Highland Game events, right? And one of them is where they hold this giant tree log. It's like 20 feet in the air. And they run holding it like this, and then they throw it, and they have to get it to flip, hit its top, and then rotate over. It's crazy. And they have the hammer throw. They have all kinds of Highland Game events, but that's closer to what you were talking about, Eric.
Totally not the game I was talking about.
No. It's not what you were talking about, Nick. But they've got those guys in the Highland Game like that compete, talk about the game that you're talking about. They don't show that, but they talk about it.
So the second Irish game that I learned about is called road bowling. Have you ever heard of road bowling?
No.
It's insane.
I won't get that.
So there's two guys that compete against each other, and they basically are on like this country road in Ireland, and you get this metal ball. I think it's metal ball. And you start from way back, and you get a running start, and you whip this ball, and you see how far you can throw it. So you do this over and over again for hours. They do it for miles and hours, and there's groups of people just following them and drinking and going crazy. And I think there's like a finish line, and I guess whoever gets there first with as few throws possible. I'm probably butchering the rules of the game, but if you
sounds about right to me.
If you go on and YouTube it, just YouTube road bowling.
Okay.
It's pretty crazy. And it's like the quintessential Irish sport where there's everybody's like screaming at the guys and chugging beers. And these guys are just going for miles hurling this metal ball.
Okay.
It's insane. Fair so right. They taught me some cool games over there.
Sounds interesting.
Check out hurling too. Like it's pretty intense, and you need some skill to play it. I mean, and you're getting beat up at the same time. So these guys are like tough dudes that are getting mangled in the face with these. They're literally like pizza paddles. They look like field hockey sticks mixed with pizza paddles.
So when you say pizza paddle, you're talking about like a pizza spatula you would put a pizza into an oven with? That's what you're talking about?
Like, yeah, similar. It's crazy. It looks like a field hockey stick mixed with a pizza paddle mixed with a lacrosse stick.
Okay.
I feel like we're talking about extreme sports right now. I mean, are we doing extreme sports or are we doing Netflix right now?
Here, it's like this.
Both?
I'll show you a picture of it.
Because it's also – this conversation is clicking on me again. I got another extreme sport.
What do you got, eh?
So you've seen the one video of them going down the hill. You know, this fucking steep hill as far down as you can possibly go. And what they do is they just run down it. And these or I think it's either they run down it or there's a big hay. There's like a big ball they catch after it, and like it's something like that. And it's it's a big thing of cheese. Big thing of cheese. They roll down the hill, and these guys just run after it, and they just they run down this hill, and they just stumble. I'm telling you, it's like classic. It's classic. All these people just go down this steep hill and just hurl themselves down this hill. And whoever gets down to the first wins. And it's I don't know. If you're talking about weird sports, that's one of them.
I have seen those Highland games where they basically have a big, it looks like a big pole vaulting pole. And they get a running start and they jam it in the ground and they have to climb up the pole. They have to climb up the pole as it's falling over.
One of them, they got the cane toss over the top of the high bar, right? You got to throw it up and over. So you got to clear a certain height and then it has to go a certain distance. And then the big game, and I can't remember the name of it. It's pissing me off. But essentially, you get a running start, and you're holding a gigantic, looks like it's just a tree. It's a 20-foot tree. Maybe not 20 feet, 10-foot tree, and it's heavy. And you hold it, like, right at your hips, and you run with it. You throw it, and it has to hit the ground and rotate over. And it's not, what's important is not how far it went, but the time measurement. Like, you want to keep it right at 12 o'clock.
The caber toss.
Caber toss, that's it. The caber toss. That's like the biggest Highland game there is, the caber toss. And it's like, it's again, not about the distance, it's about the technique. You got to get this thing to rotate over and then land if you're looking at a clock, like right at 12 o'clock, 12 to 6 is like perfect. The caber toss. Boom. Got it.
Caber toss. I like it.
Caber toss, baby.
I'm in. Where can I sign up?
Yeah, we got to set up caber toss. We're setting up Highland games up to Bridgeport Park next weekend.
Dude, get Adam on that. Get Coach T on that now.
All right, so that was it for Extreme Sports on Netflix. That's what I had to watch. You guys got anything else on Netflix you're into?
I've only watched one thing new, which I thought was highly interesting. And it was this one dude, I think his name's Scott Kelly. He's an astronaut, and he's the guy that spent the most days in space in United States history. It's called A Year in Space. I thought it was interesting. I just like that stuff. You know, this guy's living in space for a year, and I just thought it was how they live from – anyway, it's kind of cool, the terminology. He's like, dude, I'm 250 miles, you know, on the outside of Earth, 250 miles, and he's going out for the spacewalk. It's like, do you get heights when you're going out on the space station and doing work? But that was one. It was called A Year in Space, due by Scott Kelly, probably the most famous astronaut. Spent the most time in space, and I thought that was highly interesting. And
okay, so I
thought it was good.
I can vouch. I did watch A Year in Space. It is extremely interesting. I will caveat with this. I'm into space shit, right? I think it's cool.
I like it. I don't know.
I just watched again for the third time the movie Ad Astra. Right, with Brad Pitt. So if you haven't watched
it, I haven't seen that.
And you're into space,
dude,
shit,
I fell asleep. I fell asleep in 5 minutes.
Ad Astra, yeah. It's not it's not an action movie, right? It's very much a space shit movie. I don't have a better term for it right now, so I'm just going to keep saying space shit, but you got to be into it. But yeah,
I was just tired.
Well, what about the guy, Mark Wahlberg? He was in, what was that called, The Martian?
No, it was Matt Damon.
Matt Damon. Matt Damon was in The Martian. That was
a very
too.
Good movie. The Martian is a very good movie.
I thought that was good.
Interstellar is my only space movie.
Interstellar. Mr. Matthew McConaughey over here.
Well, dude, I wanted to get into – I tried to do Ad Astra. I'm not a space guy.
Yeah, Ad Astra is slow. It starts slow. I like it a lot. It's telling a deeper story, right? Ad Astra translates – to the stars, so you know there's a lot going on there.
Interstellar does too, but still.
Interstellar is long AF.
It is, but I was into it. That was the only space movie that I had. But anyway, so me, just what I'm watching, being that I only watch shows after they've been canceled for a couple of years, I'm still on Parks and Rec. So we started watching Parks and Rec, probably I'd say like 3 weeks ago, and we're almost finished all of them. We're burning through them. So it's like one of my new favorite shows. I didn't realize it was actually that funny. And now we're kind of comparing it to The Office, saying, what's better, The Office or Parks and Rec? Whereas before, I would have said, you can never touch The Office. It's like the top notch for me.
It's sacrilegious to go against The Office, even if it is Parks and Rec, which is the closest thing to The Office you're ever
going to get. It's pretty good, but I don't know if I have it better than The Office, but it's pretty good.
Yeah. So I watched the entirety of The Office over quarantine here. I never watched really any of it before, minus a couple episodes when I was up in Toronto for a bachelor party. And I got through the entirety of it. I really liked it. And now, like, Netflix be shoving Parks and Rec down my throat. Comedy Central be shoving Parks and Rec down my throat. And I've watched a couple episodes, and I like, you know, some of the people on the show, but I haven't really, like fully clicked into it yet.
Now, is that the show Is that the guy with the glasses and the real glasses with his eyes real big and then they're in there like the no, that's the wrong one. I'm not thinking the right show.
what
is that called? It's called Trailer or something.
No, you're thinking of Office Space, dude.
No, it wasn't Office Space. It's a show. It's go ahead. I thought you were speaking of a different show that I saw some of it.
I haven't seen
Parks and Rec.
What channel was it on?
It's on Netflix. I'm about to look it up real quick just so I know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I have no idea what you're talking about.
Well, I'm about to...
Some guy with glasses. All
right.
But that's what I'm watching.
He's a pretty famous guy.
And we recorded HBO. I forget the name of it. Into the Night or something. I'll be gone in the night or I'm out of here at night or something like that. Dude, help me out here.
I got nothing.
I'm looking up this show that I think that's
I don't know. I don't know. I got nothing
for you. In the dark of the night or something like that, going in the night.
I got nothing for you there. I was just going to say, just watched the new Charlize Theron movie on Netflix last night. The name is escaping me now.
Oh, here's a good one. Mysteries, right? They were pretty good.
Mysteries
did you guys watch them? I did, actually. They were pretty good.
Yeah, speaking of watching shows after they've been canceled.
Yeah.
There's all old ones?
They're good.
They're new ones?
Unsolved Mysteries. They're interesting.
Yeah, they're back. Unsolved Mysteries is back on Netflix. I think I'm only through like three of them.
I binge watched them all in one sitting.
Yeah, they're good. It's all new Unsolved Mysteries. Check that out. I can't think of the name.
They were good.
Of the Charlize Theron movie on.
So
there.
Did you watch the first one?
I watched the first one. Yeah.
Booha.
Not Unsolved Mysteries.
Unsolved Mysteries from like 1993.
It's like they're literally bringing these shows out here because they have no information on them. They're like, dude, watch put them on Netflix. Maybe we'll get a hit.
It's extremely important at this stage in my life that shows be limited to a half hour because literally
it's 45 minutes.
Every day is the same day now. And it's like after we get in our routine, it's like you sit down on the couch at the end of the day, it's like 9:30 already. And I'm about to go to sleep at 10:15. So I got one show in me, and I'm good. That's why Parks and Rec, I get two episodes in,
and
I'm
asleep. And that's about it.
Quick.
Yeah, that's how it is now.
And also, so the one show I was talking about was called the Trailer Park Boys.
Trailer Park Boys.
So the Park and Rec kind of got me up the Trailer Park Boys. Got the glasses.
So. Well, we're going to wrap up. Thanks, everybody, for hopping on the live feed. Thanks, E, for hopping on with us. Appreciate you.
Yeah, it was fun. Anytime, man.
Virtual work. I know you were worried about that.
Yeah, it was no problem. I always enjoy myself, you know, just talking whatever the hell we want to talk about. It's always a good time. Appreciate it.
Yeah, we'll do it again next week.
Sounds like we can
get Wednesday. Maybe we can get a regular Wednesday going.
Yeah, we're going to try and get back on a regular routine. It's tough, as we talked about before, because sports are just coming back. So there's not a ton to talk about. But as things come up, you guys need to hit us up. Let us know what you want us to talk about. We're happy to do it. We're happy to have fun. We appreciate everybody commenting on the live feed.
And baseball starts next week.
Oh.
Yeah, we got sports, too. Sunday, it's coming back.
We do. Don't forget, everybody. All of our podcasts are on the YouTube application and the iTunes podcast application. Search From _the_hill. Put quotations around it. Make sure you hit the subscribe button. Make sure you hit the thumbs up button. It doesn't cost you anything, but it helps us out a lot. That is it. We're going to shut it down. For Earl, for the Prof, it's Swag. Peace.
Peace.
See ya.
And I just seen a girl in here that look like a daughter. And I'ma spin these G's on. I promise I won't be the same like R. Kelly, but I promise I won't be.